Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who chooses parents, not me or you, no one. It is Allah who decides whom your father will be. And on the day of judgment, you will be called by your father's name according to the most correct narrations. In fact, that is the narration. Some people say, no, you're called with your mother's name. The truth is, it is your father's name. And Allah says, "Udu'uhum li'aba'ihim huwa aqsatu 'indallah." Call them with their father's names. That is what is justice in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You want to know what is right? You want to know what Allah declares? Allah says, I chose his father. You call him so and so, son of so and so, the real father who is his father, even if you've adopted him. So they knew that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam adopted the child and called him my son. So Allah says, do not call him your son. Say, he is the son of Haritha. Allahu Akbar. This was something heavy, but for Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was not heavy because it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it destroyed one of the deep-rooted cultures of the people at the time. They used to adopt and they used to say, that's my son. And they used to say, change the name to the degree that the child himself does not know who the father is. Subhanallah. Islam says that is prohibited. It is the right, the basic right of every human being to know who their father and mother is. Subhanallah. So if it is deception, you're not allowed. Sometimes I know in today's world, people might want to have a surname that might show that this person is part of us because we take care of them, on condition that it is not deceptive and on condition that the person knows clearly who they are. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Wallahi, it's becoming tough because sometimes we do not learn a lesson from this very story of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It was the pagan practice to say, you know, once I adopt you, forget about your parents. If you want to know them, you're no longer mine. If that is the way we think, we have forgotten what Islam stands for. These verses were solid verses that broke up a massive culture that had been trending in Makkah al-Mukarramah. And at the time, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us.